1 Kings chapter 4. So King Solomon was king over all Israel, and these were the princes which he had: Azariah, the son of Zadok the priest, Elihoreph, and Ahijah, the sons of Shisha, scribes, Jehoshaphat, the son of Ahilud, the recorder, and Benaiah, the son of Jehoiada, was over the host, and Zadok and Abiathar were the priests, and Azariah, the son of Nathan, was over the officers, and Zabud, the son of Nathan, was principal officer and the king's friend, and Ahishar was over the household, and Adoniram, the son of Abda, was over the tribute. And Solomon had 12 officers over all Israel, which provided victuals for the king and his household. Each man, his month in a year, made provision. And these are their names: the son of Hur in Mount Ephraim, the son of Dekar in Makaz, and in Shaalbim, and Beth Shemesh, and Elon Bethhanan, the son of Hesed in Aruboth. To him pertained Socah and all the land of Hefer, the son of Abinadab, in all the region of Dor, which had Taphath, the daughter of Solomon, to wife. And Baanah, the son of Ahilud, to him pertained Taanach and Megiddo, and all Bethshean, which is by Sartana, beneath Jezreel, from Bethshean to Abel-Meholah, even unto the place that is beyond Jokneam. The son of Geber in Ramoth-Gilead, to him pertained the towns of Jair. The son of Manasseh, which are in Gilead, to him also pertained the region of Argob, which is in Bashan. 70 great cities with walls and brazen bars. Ahinadab, the son of Iddo, had Mahanaim. Ahimaaz was in Naphtali. He also took Basmath, the daughter of Solomon, to wife. Baanah, the son of Hushai, was in Asher and in Eloth. Jehoshaphat, the son of Parua, in Issachar. Shimei, the son of Elah, in Benjamin. Geber, the son of Uri, was in the country of Gilead, in the country of Sihon, king of the Amorites, and of Og, king of Bashan. And he was the only officer which was in the land. Judah and Israel were many as the sand which is by the sea in multitude, eating and drinking and making merry. And Solomon reigned over all kingdoms from the river unto the land of the Philistines and unto the border of Egypt. They brought presents and served Solomon all the days of his life. And Solomon's provision for one day was 30 measures of fine flour and 70 measures of meal, 10 fat oxen and 20 oxen out of the pastures, and 100 sheep, beside harts and roebucks and fallow deer and fatted fowl. For he had dominion over all the region on this side the river, from Tipsah even to Azah, over all the kings on this side the river, and he had peace on all sides round about him. And Judah and Israel dwelt safely, every man under his vine and under his fig tree, from Dan even to Beersheba, all the days of Solomon. And Solomon had 40,000 stalls of horses for his chariots, and 12,000 horsemen. And those officers provided victual for King Solomon and for all that came unto King Solomon's table. Every man in his month they lacked nothing. Barley also, and straw for the horses, and dromedaries brought they unto the place where the officers were, every man according to his charge. And God gave Solomon wisdom and understanding, exceeding much, and largeness of heart, even as the sand that is on the seashore. And Solomon's wisdom excelled the wisdom of all the children of the east country, and all the wisdom of Egypt. For he was wiser than all men, than Ethan the Israelite, and Heman, and Chalcol, and Darda the sons of Mahal. And his fame was in all nations round about. And he spake 3,000 proverbs, and his songs were 1,005. And he spake of trees, from the cedar tree that is in Lebanon, even unto the hyssop that springeth out of the wall. He spake also of beasts, and of fowl, and of creeping things, and of fishes. And there came of all people to hear the wisdom of Solomon, from all kings of the earth, which had heard of his wisdom.